talking the last couple weeks about daring to dream, for those of you who haven't been here. First, we talked about Langston Hughes, who dared to dream to be a great writer and tell his story through poetry. And last week, we talked about Robert Battles, who dared to dream to be a dancer, even though when he was born, his legs were not able to move very well. And this week, we're going to talk about someone who dared to dream of special music. Now, first, we're going to hear a little music about what I sound like today. Let's see if we can get it out. Nope, I got it. This is how I play now. I didn't always play this way, but this is what I sound like. And I put together a special mix of music of how I thought it should be. I put together jazz, I put together gospel, I put together spiritual, I added a little rock and roll, some funk, some hip hop, and I call it my own kind of music. It's called Super Fun Rock. That's my style of music. Now, that's what he calls it, super funk rock. That's his kind of music. So this is my story, but today we have to participate because in my town of Treme, where I came from, we don't just say, "Hi Charlie, how's it going?" We say, "Where are you at?"
Where are you at?
So when I point to you in the story, you're gonna say, just like when you listen to your favorite song, you start at the beginning, I'm going to start at the beginning of my story. But before you can understand how much music means to me, you have to know how important it is to my hometown. That's my inspiration. I grew up in a neighborhood just outside of New Orleans called Treme. Any time or day or night, you could hear music floating all around me. In my very own house, my grandpa was a musician, and my brother James played in a band. He had his very own band. He was the loudest in the block. You could hear him playing his trumpet all over the place, and I pretended to play along with him. Now, my favorite time of year, in fact, it's happening right now down in Louisiana, is Mardi Gras. The bands come marching down, the big brass bands, and necklaces are thrown around. I loved the brass bands with their own trumpets and trombones and saxophones and the biggest brass instrument of them all, the tuba that went over your shoulders. Well, the musician would call out,
"Where are you at?"
And I loved listening to it all. All day long, I could see brass bands parade by my house and my neighbors danced along. I loved because Mardi Gras made everyone kind of forget about things that weren't going so well. We didn't have a lot of money, we didn't have a lot of things in Treme, but we had the Mardi Gras. Now, I listened to all kinds of music around the town, and the music there was kind of like our favorite dish. We take a big pot, we throw chicken and shrimp and crab and sausage and vegetables and rice in there, cook it all up till it was delicious, and we called it gumbo. We called it gumbo, and that's the kind of thing that my music was going to be like. I was going to mix all my music together to make a new special kind of music, and what was it called, Charlie? Do you remember? Super funk rock. My new kind of favorite music. But I love to play music, but first I needed an instrument. Now keep in mind, I'm only 4 years old. I don't have an instrument, and my friends didn't have any instruments, but we made our own instruments. We took an empty carton of pot, we took a Mardi Gras bead, and we broke it off, and we made it like this. We used sticks to make a drum. I took a big wheel that I had, and I put it up over my shoulder, and I pretended it was a tuba. I took bottles, and I blew over them like it was a trumpet or a wind instrument. Now, we may not have sounded the best, and we sounded a little different, but we were the greatest musicians of Treme. We were making music, and that's all that mattered. But then one day, I found a broken trombone in the garbage. I was so excited, I thought, now I have a real instrument to play. So the next time the brass bands came by my house, I ran out in front and I started playing as much as I could along with the bands. And my brother saw me and thought it was so funny. He said, look at that, it's Trombone Shorty. And that was my nickname from then on, because the trombone was three times as big as me, because I was only 4 years old. And so the crowd said, so from that day on, everywhere I went, my trombone came with. I practiced day and night. The songs that I heard my brother James' band playing, I practiced those. And I sometimes even fell asleep with my trombone. And sometimes I would even fall over because the trombone was so big, because remember, I'm only 4 years old. But I practiced and practiced, and I learned all those songs that my brother's band played. Now, when I was 5 years old, my mother surprised me. She bought me tickets to the New Orleans Jazz Festival. And playing there, she told me, was the most important musician of all times to her, Bo Diddley. So I went there to the concert, and the band started playing up in front, and I just picked up my trombone, because I took it with me everywhere, and I started playing along. All of a sudden, Bo Diddley stopped the music. He said, who is playing out there? Well, all the people started pointing to me, but because I was so little, no one could see me. So mothers, being as embarrassing as they are, she held me up over her shoulder and she said, it's my son, Trombone Shorty. Both of them said, well, Trombone Shorty, come on up here. So the crowd passed me over their heads, up to the stage, till I was next to Bo Diddley himself. Now I want you to look back here for a second. You can see that far. There's me with Bo Diddley. Playing my trombone. So Bo Diddley said, what are we going to play? And being the confident little boy that I was, keep in mind, he's 5 years old now, held my trombone up and I said, follow me. So after I played that day with Bo Diddley, I knew music was my dream. So I put together my own band, and we called ourselves the 5 o'clock band, because we could only play at 5 o'clock after we did our homework. So we were called the 5 o'clock band, and we played and we practiced, and I got so good that I was ever able to play with my brother James's band. And my brother was so proud. Every time somebody would say, who's that? He'd say, that's my brother, Trombone Shorty. Yeah. All right, so I continued to practice and dream. And I played with all sorts of famous people. Lenny Kravitz, U2, Green Day, Bo Diddley, of course, B.B. King, and I even got to play at the White House for Barack Obama, President Barack Obama. Because I worked, I dared to dream, I thought I can follow it. But the most important thing to me nowadays is that I go back to New Orleans as often as I can to be able to encourage others to dream their dream, just like I'm encouraging you today. Whatever that dream will be, maybe you didn't know it at 4 years old like Trombone Shorty did, but when that dream hit you, like the spirit hit Josephine earlier, when that spirit hit you, whether it's a Monday, a Tuesday, a Wednesday, a Thursday, or a Friday, I want you to dare to dream that dream. Let's pray. God, you are with us in our dreams. Help us to see that we can do anything with your help. As long as we practice, have those around us who love and care for us, our dream can come true.